extended coverage of the storms that are rolling through the center of the country. Damage in the wake of these storms certainly evident in Washington, Illinois, where you see trees literally snapped in half and just debris everywhere strewn across an entire neighborhood. Coal City, Illinois, another place where you have homes destroyed. And again, you can just see unbelievable pictures that have been coming in as we go throughout the afternoon heading into the evening hours. Peoria, Illinois. See all that pink there? That's insulation. That tells you that someone's roof was ripped off and everything underneath it now strewn across the neighborhood. That's the kind of damage that we're seeing. And here, a fire truck, an emergency response vehicle that is under a roof that has collapsed on top of them in Kokomo, Indiana. And flooding, also a problem as we've had a lot of rain with this system. This a picture in Harrods Creek where we've seen the water rise right up to the door handles of this SUV. Another example of the power of these storms. Now, these storms are continuing right now. Again, you can see this one in Brookport, Illinois. But where we've got tornado warnings right this hour is in Ohio. And our severe weather expert, Dr. Forbes, is tracking them. Dr. Forbes, what can we tell people about where these storms are moving to next?
Yeah, we have off around Marion, Ohio, and east of Cincinnati. But what I wanted to do first was go back to, we've been talking all afternoon, saying we weren't sure what it was that was damaged there in Washington, Illinois. We've been showing pictures from the ground. Let's take a look here. We have a before and after aerial photograph. This is Washington, Illinois. Look at all of these. The gray shape, that's the shingles on the roof. Beautifully designed, clean community there. Now, Adam, advance it. Let's go and take a look what has happened. Now, here's the tornado. Piles of rubble. So all those piles of rubble that we said we didn't know what they were, we now know what they were. Some of the worst hit there were houses that have been completely leveled. So this is likely to be an EF3 or higher rated tornado. And that's part of these red dots that are hidden here in among all these blue severe wind reports, about 400 all told, and more than 60 reports of tornadoes. We don't know how many actual individual tornadoes that has been. Now, at the moment, almost out of Michigan, north central Ohio, down though to Cincinnati area and across parts of Kentucky and Tennessee are where the storms continue as this line begins to weaken a little bit, but still marching east. Taking a look at some of the storms here. One of the tornado warnings looks like it's about ready to expire here around the Marion and Wyandotte counties in Ohio. That's well to the west of, and southwest of the Cleveland area. Still, though, a tornado warning there for just a few more minutes. Then farther south in Ohio, this is off to the east of Cincinnati, Brown and Highland counties. Possible circulations in this first line. And then there's yet another line behind that with a tornado warning for Claremont County. So a couple of possible lines of storms there. The storms, though, have cleared the Cincinnati area. Up in the Detroit area, the storms now all but a little bit of Oakland County. The storms have cleared you as well. But Cleveland, they're heading your way. There's the viewpoint out of Detroit. Things looking a lot better than they have over the past half hour. Down coming toward the Cincinnati area, severe thunderstorm warnings all the way then across from north central to southwest Ohio, Erie and Sandusky counties included in that. Then here's a broader picture. There's Cleveland. So quite a line of thunderstorms with damaging winds, and can't totally rule out a tornado. No tornado warnings immediately for the Cincinnati, for the Cleveland area. Seneca County included in the warnings. Here's the rough timeline. Cleveland, approximately 7:35 when those damaging winds might come in. Akron, about 8:18 as this whole line of thunderstorms comes east at about 50 miles per hour. Jumping down then into Kentucky, southern Kentucky, Bowling Green, quite a line of storms from around Campbellsville to Bowling Green to coming toward the Franklin area. Severe thunderstorm warnings for many counties there. And then off into parts of Tennessee, severe thunderstorm warnings coming toward, and a whole line extends down off to the north of Memphis. So we may build the line down toward Memphis over the next hour to 2 hours. A line of thunderstorms coming down toward the Nashville area. I've timed that one out probably about 7 o'clock central time, a little bit more than an hour from now. The damaging wind threat may come into you. Not every one of these at the moment is looking like a severe thunderstorm. And here is one warning there off to the east of Dyersburg in Tennessee. All of these storms today have been courtesy of this upper air system. The strongest part of the cold pocket aloft is actually running northeast with and then drier air is coming in aloft toward parts of the Kentucky, Tennessee. That's these red or orange colors. But the whole weather system and its cold front are going to continue pushing east with damaging wind gusts becoming the main mode of severe weather overnight, especially parts of Ohio, Pennsylvania, northern New Jersey, New York State, maybe all the way by pre-dawn to New York City. And in parts of the areas farther to the south, it might get a little bit spottier. Tomorrow we'll have damaging winds. continue in a low-level jet that's ahead of that cold front. So in the morning hours from the mid-Atlantic up into New England, and then later on in the day, the afternoon time frame up in parts of the Great Lakes states, a pretty windy day. So, Chris, it is going to be, again, a windy day tomorrow, but the main tornado threat is a little bit on the wane still. Lots of damaging wind gusts yet to go across parts of the Tennessee, Ohio valleys, and into the mid-Atlantic and northeast yet tonight, Chris.
Dr. Forbes, thank you for that. And we are in the middle of a severe weather outbreak, so stay with us for more expert analysis only the Weather Channel can bring you. Also, the very latest pictures from the places that have been hit the hardest. And remember, coverage of today's severe weather outbreak continues on air.